appropriately. And Johnny's uncle was one, which is... Johnny, we never knew that.
Genuine,
I'm really impressive. Shin-kicking was a popular sport in Lancashire pubs for 150 years. Now, here's a pub in Lancashire. My question is, how did Spanking Roger woo the ladies?
I love that pub.
Do you know it?
Yeah, I do.
Where is it?
It's in, like... I think it's in Kersal or Salford area.
It's Manchester area, quite right.
When I went to university, I know, I did. I lived in a place called Castle Irwell, which was a dog track before we... before
destroyed
it became a student village. Yeah. but every year, there was a race down the hill naked. And you would run down around this thing. All the blokes would. I didn't, obviously. Weird. I didn't have I'm a grower, not a shower. And this pub was part, I think the guy Spanking Roger, how he got his wife. I think there was something to do with his wife where he was naked and she had a little look. He was quite well and down. I thought, I'll have him.
You're right. Well, this naked running was on Kersal Moor.
Kersal Moor, which has now become Castle Irwell, which is now Student Village.
That's exactly it's the same place, it. We've got a picture as it used to be, which is beautiful.
Yeah, no, it was much more of a shithole when I was there.
No, exactly. Now it's just vomit and empty Pringles tubes.
Yeah. Well, that guy, Spanking Roger, even though it sounds like he was a bit of an idiot, he ended up being a big guy in the army. Like, he fought... I think he defended Gibraltar or something like that.
Yeah, absolutely right. He was the great hero of Gibraltar. This is brilliant. He's on fire.
Slumdog Millionaire or something like that going, how did you know that one?
It is your manner, isn't it?
That's where I grew up, around the corner from there.
And he was a fascinating character, Spanking Roger, as he was known. He was from Scotland, actually. He was in the Scots Dragoons.
Oh, okay,
and he came down 6'4" high and of ample endowment, it seems, because he did do the naked run.
That's why it's called Spanking Roger.
He could only do it in the summer where the slapping didn't hurt him quite so much. But he did catch the eye of a 65-year-old widow whom he married.
Caught
her in the eye. Her name was Minchel, Barbara Minchel.
That's right, which is the Minchel Courts in Manchester. And Minchel Street is where, that's where her family...
She was a rich family.
And I think she died.
She's back in the 1760s when they married. And the next day he was immediately betraying her and spending all her money. And he spent it on, essentially, he would bare-knuckle fights. If anybody beat him, they were sort of free, but if he beat them, he dragooned them, as it were.
Is that why he's called Spanking Roger?
He's called Spanking Roger because he fought. He was a brilliant bare-knuckle fighter. Yeah, that's exactly the reason. And life was extraordinary because he, as you rightly say, was the hero of Gibraltar with this dragooned army there. It was the longest siege in British military history, held up for 4 years. And kept the rock, as we still have at time of going to press, unless the Spanish have had something to do with it. His wife died, he got into terrible debt, came back impoverished, found another woman whom he married, she was Scottish, and he died a very rich man indeed. So he had a pretty splendid life. Mm. A spanking life, in fact.
Why do they say spanking for good in England? All that spanking good time and...
It's a very good point, isn't it? The great, much-lamented Christopher Hitchens once said, there is no surname in English that cannot be improved by having the word spanker put in front of it. Spanker Manford. Spanker Vegas. Spanker Bee. Spanker Bee is terrific, isn't it?
There's the queen bee. There's worker bees. And then there's the spanker bee.
I bumped into old Spanker Davies at the club the other day. Well, Spanking Roger didn't spank ladies, he spanked the French and the Spanish. Roger was a strapping 6'4" with a Scottish accent, but what's short, talks gibberish and is much sought after in Merseyside.
Johnny's uncle.
He's a diddy man.
It's not the diddy man, though oddly enough, you could barely be closer. In Liverpool, there was this, there it is, in case you wanted to know.